floor joists in a mobile home are 2x4s, 1.5 by 3.5. People need to be moving into this mobile home sometime in early October, and it's September 4th, so we've got to get it done. They're coming to hang some sheetrock later today. Thank you. So there's the floor joists of mobile homes. See, it's only like 2x4s. It actually is 1.5 by 3.5. And there's the axle that goes over to the other wheel. And I'll let you see the tire over here. This is the power coming in. This would be the wire going over to the other end of the light. This one's going to be the light. So I'll leave this one up here. Okay, I'm going to put a staple up here so this doesn't get pushed against the metal that's up here. Same with this one here, I'll get one up here. Okay, so this one's the power coming in, so we will put that one down here in the back. We'll put some screws in this box afterwards, but I just don't have a drill bit with a screw gun on it, so I'm just going to wire it together so it's ready to go. This one's the power coming in. Sometimes you have to just force it. When you force something, you want to make sure you don't damage it. Because unfortunately, that's what happens a lot of the time when you force things, so you got to be careful. This one's going to be the power. This one's going to be the up above light here. Damn. This is the overhead light. So I have to bring some water up. Let it fall. I don't care. Okay, this is going to be the outside light here. So now we can start wiring this box up. This is the power. Make sure all the debris is out. So we can bring that up a little bit. Just stay the fuck in there, goddammit. So we'll get all our ground wires together. Now we're getting a shitty twist about here, but I'm going to be cutting off where that is. See, the shitty twist starts here, so I'm going to cut it right behind all that shit. So now we're gonna have a nice, neat twist right here. As I say, we're gonna put some screws in here to hold this, but I just don't have them, so I put the staples in it just to hold it in place so I can wire it and put it together, so when they come with the screw gun and the sheetrock, I'll pull that staple out and I'll put the screws in the way it should be. I want to just have it held in place so I can do the wiring. Okay, so I'll push all the white wires back into here. Okay, all the white wires are going to go together here. So I'm going to strip these kind of long in case it comes out shitty. I can cut that part off and put a nice, neat twist under the wire nut. Boy, that all came out nice, didn't it? I like it. Cut the end off so it's even. Okay, so this one is the power coming in. Okay, so this is going to be the outlet, so that's going to go with the, so this one's a light, and this one's a light, and that one's a light, so these three go together here. Them off so they're even. Now I would have done a skin and go around the screw to save this wire nut, but well, I will do that. I will skin it. I just don't have a blade and I'll just peel it off the hard way. You can always do it the hard way when you don't have the right stuff. But you just want to make sure it's safe, that's all. Okay, so we're going to make a score here, and we're going to make a score here, and I'll just score it with a little bit of a knife that I have. See the little sharp edge I have here, so I'll just try to do it the hard way like that. Or I could break it off this way, or I could just try to... There's always another way to do things. You just gotta make sure it's safe and right. Oh, this. Hey, that worked pretty good. So I didn't have to do it the hard way. Okay, so I'll have to pull that back a little bit because I. Stripped a little too much off. So I'm going to take my pliers and hold here, and I'll go back a little bit. Alright, that might be. I don't like that. Come back up just to here. There, so I'm going to just make sure I get the copper under the screw head, but not the insulation. I don't want to get the insulation under there. Just push back that piece of the insulation here to make sure it's not under the screw head. So we'll put the outside light on the first switch here. You always put your wire around the screw the direction that the screw turns. Okay, now this is going to be the living room light here. That skin and the wire would have been a lot easier with a sheetrock knife, but what I did with my wire strippers worked. You just want to make sure you don't get any of the insulation under the screw. Okay, so we'll do the ground wire. We'll go around the green screw like that. And we'll do the same with this one. Okay, so we'll fold these into the box like this. Make sure the ground wires are down. And that will be screwed in after the sheetrock goes up. Okay, so we'll put our box up here for the light. So I got the whole front all done.
I got that. Grab that step ladder for me, Moon, real quick. Nice.
Wow. Really kicking ass, dude.
Yes. Okay. So I get the step up here. The light will go up.
I got a step ladder for you.
Okay, good.
I don't want to overwork you.
Hey, watch my camera there.
Yep, yeah, I see him.
Oh, watch the camera.
All right. Oh, I'm gonna stop. Yep. Okay.